Contracts mean different things to different people. To a lawyer, a contract is a reciprocal commitment between two or more parties that is legally binding and enforceable. The contract defines the rights and obligations of the parties involved. In economic terms, a contract is primarily a bilateral coordination arrangement that sets out how parties will work together. Here, contracting is discussed from a project management perspective, considering economic and legal aspects relevant to the practitioner, but with a focus on contracting as a tool to achieve effective project control. With this in mind, the following definition will be used in this course. A contract is a legally binding, enforceable, and reciprocal commitment governing the collaboration between two or more parties. In project management, the term contracting, contract agreement, is often used for services, for instance, engineering construction. And the term procurement, purchase order, is used for goods, for instance, bulk materials and equipment items. From a legal perspective, however, there's no distinction. Both are contracts. Essential elements of contract formation are indicated in the figure. The concept of offer and acceptance is at first sight simple and straightforward. In practice, however, complications arise on a regular basis. A statement can only be qualified as an offer if it defines the following main elements: the scope of work, price and payment provisions, and terms and conditions, as illustrated in the figure. These elements are interrelated. In the contract, a fit-for-purpose balance is established through an iterative process of qualifications and negotiation during the tendering and award process. The main and essential elements of a contract are the intent to create a legal relationship and the legal capacity to act, an offer and an acceptance and compliance with established practice and the law. In principle, parties have freedom of contract. This means they can stipulate anything they like in their contract, provided it does not contravene the law and it is feasible. A contract to build a perpetual motion machine, for instance, would not be possible. Contracts are only binding on the contracting parties and generally not subject to any format. This means they can be oral as well as written. Obviously, the main problem with oral contracts is that it can be hard to prove what exactly has been agreed. This is the main reason why contracts are usually written. We have mentioned stakeholders before, but in this case, the roles of some of the stakeholders are clearly different than before. The authorities play an important role through the applicable law, rules and regulations, as well as requirements on participation of local companies, subsidies, etc. Non-governmental organizations, NGOs, may also play a role. The interests of these stakeholders are in many cases, but not always, aligned with those of the local community. Their role pertains to the boundary conditions for project execution, and early engagement with them is critical to project success. Some of them are only involved in the project around the contract signing ceremony and the opening ceremony. In between, however, the real work happens. The roles of some of the stakeholders are definitely different from others. Whilst the contract is only binding for the parties to the contract, the owner and the contractor, it exists and operates within a context of related contracts and stakeholders as indicated in the figure. Insurers and lenders facilitate the execution of the project. They play a more direct role in the contractual relationship between owner and contractor, and so do the licensors. In case things go wrong, if you have to refer to the contract in order to convince your counterpart, you are on a slippery slope. Big chance that the relationship goes sour and claims will be going back and forth. Not the way to go. In the ideal case, after signing the contract, you preferably do not want to see the lawyers back in your project team. In this short video, we have given you a lot of information. It is probably best to read it back once more and study a number of the concepts in a bit more detail. What we want you to remember, however, is that also in the case of contracting, it are the people that make the difference. It is the relationship that counts far more than the contract type or the small print.